Table types. Table types are construction blueprints for internal tables that are stored in the ABAP dictionary. When you create a table type in the ABAP dictionary, you specify the line type, access type, and key. The line type can be any data type from the ABAP dictionary, that is, a data element, a structure, a table type, or the type of a database table. In an ABAP program, you can use the type addition to refer directly to a table type. Let's create a table type in the ABAP dictionary. Back in the system, we navigate to the ABAP dictionary transaction SE11, and then we select data type and we write the name for our table type. So I like using the T for table type underscore flight report. We're going to create a table type for the flight report. We select table type and we write a short text and we specify a line type. In this line type, we can specify a structure, a database table, a view, or another table type. Let's look for a structure. So let's look for a structure that we created previously. So we type ZST for structure, and we place the asterisk and we click on the search icon. The search hub pops up and we search for structures. And we have our flight report structure. We select it, we double click, and we save our table type. When we double click, it takes us to the structure. So we're going to create a table type that contains all these fields. So we click enter. Another option is we can also define a predefined type, and we can create a table type, for example, for strings, or a reference type, and we can create a table type for a reference. We also have the initialization and access tab, and we want this access to be a standard table, a sorted table, hash, index, or not specified. Most of the time we work with standard tables. Even when we declare inside the ABAP code the internal tables, most of the time they are standard tables. So we leave it with standard table. And the key, if we want to define a key for this table type. So let's just select standard key, and it can be a non-unique key. So this way we can create an internal table with a lot of data. So when we have that, we can activate our table type, and it is active. Now we can use it inside a program. Let's copy this and let's go back and let's navigate to our flight report program. So we go to transaction SE80 and we go to our package, cflight, enter, programs, and we have our flight report. So we selected everything from SFlight into the corresponding fields, and then we printed that to the screen. So let's click on display change and let's declare a local table of flight report type, our table type. And let's declare a working area of the flight report, like line of our table type. So now let's populate our table. So for in the select, after we perform the add and the move, we're going to populate our fly report. I'm sorry, our fly report working area. How do we do that? We use the move corresponding. So we move the contents of the first structure to our working area, and then we append our working area to our internal table. And now we can work with this internal table. So for example, we can loop at our internal table into our working area again, and we can write to the screen the side tabix or the current length of our table, so we can print how many records we have in our table. So let's check the syntax and activate, and let's run our program. Erlang code, flight 17, and as you can see here we print 14 records, and here we have 14 records. So our internal table work as we planned, and we use the table type to declare an internal table of this type. Visibility of global and local data objects. Variables defined in the main program are global data objects. They are visible, can be addressed in the entire main program in every subroutine called. Variables defined within a subroutine are called local, as they only exist in the relevant subroutine, just like the formal parameters. The formal parameters and local data objects of a subroutine cannot have the same names. You can use the following prefixes for your subroutine objects: F for formal parameters and L for local data objects. Or as you can see in the examples that we built before, the system uses the letter P for parameter.